Hello children, welcome you all once again to my YouTube channel. I am your English teacher. Today we shall read two new lessons from your NCERT textbook English Marigold book 4. Unit number 8. The lessons are books. Going to buy a book. Let's see. Read and learn this poem, Books. Come in, said the library door. I opened it wide and saw books galore. Tall, skinny books up high on the shelves, little fat books that stood by themselves. I opened one off and sat down to look. The pictures told stories. What a wonderful book. New words. Library, wide, galore. Skinny, shelves, wonderful. So in this poem, we find some rhyming words, door, galore, self, themselves, look, book, and these rhymings make this poem more interesting to read. Now let's read this poem once more. Come in, said the library door. I opened it wide and saw books galore. Tall, skinny books up high on the shelves. Little fat books that stood by themselves. I opened one off and sat down to look. The pictures told stories. What a wonderful books. This poem tells us about how we should appreciate the books. Why we should develop a keen interest in the books. Because books are wonderful. They have pictures that told stories. See, and the places where we keep them, the shelves. And there are different kinds of books, tall, skinny books. See, library is a place where you will find a lot of books. Reading is fun. What did the library door say? What did the books in the library look like? Why did the child in the poem like looking at the pictures? Just give it a thought. Moving on, let's listen. Listen to the words. Come in. Go out. What would signs have you seen or heard? At home, at the vegetable shop, at the library, at the doctor's place, at the bus stop, at the toy shop. Let's talk. Do you like reading storybooks? What kind of stories do you like? The word galore means in great numbers. Do you also have a class library or a school library which keeps many books? Can you borrow books? Tell the class about your favorite storybook. Talk about the character you like most in the book. fun time. Let's play book chain. Form groups of 5 or 6 children in the class. Sit in circles. The first child will begin the book chain by saying the name of a story book. The next child extends the chain by saying the name of another book. In this way, a book chain is formed. The more the rounds the children can go on for, the longer the book chain will be. See which group makes the longest book chain. Okay, you can see Aesop's Fables, Panchatantra, Fairy Tales, Arabian Nights, Indian Folk Tales. Let's write. Magwood families, the first word in it has been written for you. Well, tell, and remaining, you can see, see, book. Look at this sentence. A library is a place where books are kept. Now fill in the blanks after reading these sentences. 1. And dash is a place where aeroplanes take off and land. 2. A dash is a place where food is cooked. 3. A dash is a place where sick people are taken care of. 4. A dash is a place where you can buy things. 5. A dash is a place where children study. Now moving on to the next lesson. Let's read and enjoy. This lesson is again another poem, and it is also about books. Going to buy a book. One day, grandfather gave my brother and me some money. Go and buy books, he said. We were both very happy. We both loved to read. Should we go now? Should we go later? Should we go today? Should we go tomorrow? We decided to go right now. You can see bookshops and 2 children. There is also a shopkeeper. Continue reading. Should we go to the big market? Should we go to the small shops? Should we go with somebody? Should we go alone? We decided to go to the small shop, just the 2 of us. We like the small bookshops. It is small, but it has many books. The man in the shop likes us. He always helps us. Should I buy a book with a lot of pictures? Should I buy a book with a lot of stories? Should I buy a thin book? I could not decide. We did not know which book to buy. The man in the shop smiled at us. Relax, come with me. He said, these books are about animals. Those are about machines. Those over there are about wars. Take what you want. I picked some books, my brother picked some books. I sat on the floor, he sat on the chair, and I read and we read and we read. It was very quiet, there was no sound. 1 hour passed, 2 hours passed. Finally, we knew which books to buy. The man in the bookshop smiled at us. I got a fat book with many stories. My brother got a big book with many pictures. We ran home to our grandfather. We climbed on his bed. He put his arms around us, and then we read and read and read. And this poem is written by Rukmini Banerjee. New Woods. Alone, bookshop, machines, finally, climbed. Reading is fun. Why did grandfather give the children money? Where did they go to buy books? Did the girl buy a picture book? Let's listen and search. In small groups, one child will give directions orally only once. The others will listen and hunt for the following: a circle, a square, a triangle, a piece of paper with three signatures, a piece of paper with red color, a piece of paper with a number, a piece of paper with a label of T, a twig in the shape of an alphabetic or letter, a slab of mud with a drawing, a flower in the shape of a number. Moving on to the next exercise, let's talk. Is there a bookshop near your home? If there is, do you like to visit it? What are the different kinds of books in this bookshop or in any other bookshop you have seen? Tell the class. Next exercise, writing section. Let's write. Look at these sentences in the story. A. Should we go to the big market? Should we go to the small shop? Should I buy a thin book? Big, small, thin. The colored words above are describing words. Now fill in more describing words into the passages below. It was a dash night. A dash girl sat up in bed listening to her mother tell a dash story. Her dash eyes opened wide and she gave a dash smile. Now go to sleep, Paro. Her mother closed the book dash dreams. 2. Imagine that you will go to the bookshop tomorrow. What will you do there? Write 5 sentences beginning with I shall. The sentence will begin with I shall. 5 sentences. Moving on. Tina goes to her school Tina goes to her school library to borrow a book. Complete her dialogue with the librarian by using and, or in the blanks. Tina: Ma'am, I want to borrow a book. Librarian: They want a storybook dash a book of poems. Tina: I want a storybook. Librarian: Do you like stories about animals dash adventure stories? Tina: I like both. Librarian: Go to the second cupboard. On the first shelf, you will find animal stories dash on the second adventure stories. Tina: After selecting 2 books, ma'am, I want Black Beauty dash Panchatantra stories. Librarian: You can have either Black Beauty dash Panchatantra stories. What is your favorite book? Write down the name of the book, then write down the story. Let's make a bookmark. Make your own bookmark. Remember to treat your books well. Never fold the corners of pages. This makes books look savvy and old. A bookmark helps you to find the page you were on when you last read your book. Here is a way to make your own beautiful dove bookmark. You need an old greetings card, wedding card, scissor, a black bindi for the eye. Methods: Take the old card. You will need to use the inside of the card. Fold it into 2 as shown in the picture. Trace the outline of a dove on the card. Cut it along the lines. Make an outline with a black pen. Stick a bindi for the eye. Paste it on a strip of 2 inches into 4 inches. Your DAF bookmark is now ready to be used. Try this. Now let's cover our book. Spread your notebook on a brown paper, which is 4 inches bigger than your notebook, as shown in the picture. Fold the paper into two halves with the book inside it in the middle. Fold the two open leaves of paper inside the first and the last page of the book and press to crease. Fold the closed end of the two tops and bottom flaps of the paper, forming a triangle. Crease the paper and cut it. Fold the two front flaps inside the first page and crease it. Fold the two back flaps under the large page and crease it. Now your book is neatly covered. Write your name and class on the cover, then write the subject you will use this notebook for. So you can see the picture at the side. Do you know, the earliest books were written by hand 2000 years ago in India. Birch bark, bhojpatra, and palm leaves, talapatra, were used for pages. A pen and black ink were used to write on birch bark. A soft iron spike was used for writing on palm leaves. Holes were drilled through the leaves and the book was held together by a string. Palm leaf, birch bark. Enjoy and read the poem. Here's another short poem. Say in chorus, books are great, books are fun. Books let you do what you have never done. Read a good mystery, solve a crime. Read about history, go back in time. Mystery, history, crime, time. It's rhyming. Perfect. Read about a lost dog, where can it be? Read about a giant frog under the sea. Double rhyming, dog, frog, B, C. Okay. Read a very funny book, tears go away. Read a bright, sunny book on a rainy day. Let's read this again. It's very interesting. Books are great, books are fun. Books let you do what you have never done. Fun done. Read a good mystery, solve the crime. Read about history, go back in time. Read about a lost dog, where can it be? Read about a giant frog under the sea. Read a very funny book, tears go away. Read a bright sunny book on a rainy day. Chorus. Books are great, books are fun. Let's read books everywhere, everyone. Books are great, books are fun. Let's read books, everyone. And this short poem is written by Mass Goldfish. And it's adapted. Now let's come to the second part of the session. Let's try to solve the question, answers and exercises we just read out. Books. The first poem. And here are the new words. Library, white, galore, skinny, selves, wonderful. Now let's use them into sentences. Library, meaning a room containing collections of books. Example sentences. I have a library near my house. There is an outstanding collection of books in our school library. Next word, wide, meaning to a great extent. Example sentences. 1. The old man was walking on a wide road. 2. His eyes opened wide after hearing the news. Next word, galore. In abundance. Galore meaning in abundance. Example sentences. 1. There were chocolates galore for everything. 2. Daffodils galore in my garden. Next word, skinny, meaning very thin. Example sentences. 1. Rina has skinny legs. 2. The hockey players of our team were very skinny. Shelves. Next word, shelves, meaning a support for holding objects. Example sentences. 1. There were 5 books on the shelves. 2. The shelves were broken. Next word, wonderful, meaning something that gives pleasure. Example sentences. She was looking wonderful in the party. The principal gave a wonderful response after the function. Okay, let's come to the question answers part. What did the library door say? Answer, the library door said, come in, come in. Question 2. What did the books in the library look like? Answer, the books in the library look tall and skinny. Why did the child in the poem like looking at the pictures? Answer, the child in the poem liked looking at the pictures because it told stories. Next exercise, listen to the words. Come in, come in, go out, go out. What word signs have you seen or heard? At home, at the vegetable shop, at the library, at the doctor's place, at the bus stop, at the toy shop. Now let's see the answers. At home, we say welcome. At the vegetable shop, please do not bargain. At the library, keep silence. At the doctor's place, stay healthy. At the bus stop, please stand in a line. At the toy shop, come, let's play. Next, do you like reading storybooks? So this is a sample answer provided to you. Students are requested to write the answers based on their own experiences. Answers may vary from one student to another. Some will say, yes, I like reading storybooks. It makes me feel happy. Question 2. What kinds of stories do you like? Again, answers may vary from one student to another. Some will say, I like to read mysterious stories. The word gala means in great numbers. Do you also have a class library or a school library which keeps many books? Can you borrow books? Again, answer may vary from one student to another. This is a sample answer. Yes, I have a school library which keeps many books. Yes, I can borrow books for a week from there. Now, moving on. Tell the class about your favorite storybook. Talk about the character you like most in the book. This is again a sample answer. My favorite storybook is Alice in Wonderland. The rabbit is my favorite character in the story. It is because he wears funny clothes, he is excited every time, and then at the same time is also very shy. It is only because of the charm of the rabbit that Alice went down the rabbit hole. He becomes extremely nervous when he has to meet the queen. Moving on, let's play book chain. This one is a group activity and it is to be done with your friends in the classroom. Moving on, make word families. The first word in each has been written for you. Okay, well, tell, see, book. Let's see. What does the answer say? Well, shall, bell, spell, tell. L. Tell, mel, trail, rel. C. 3 B 3 Ook Book Look Crook Shook Brook. Next one. Next part. An airport is a place where aeroplanes take off and land. A hotel is a place where food is cooked. A hospital is a place where sick people are taken care of. A market is a place where you can buy things. Number 5, a school is a place where children study. Moving on to the next lesson, going to buy a book. Here are the new words: alone, bookshop, machines, finally, climbed. Now let's use these words into sentences. First word, alone, meaning when no one else is present. Example sentences. 1. I will stay alone at home in the evening. 2. The teacher was sitting alone in the class. Next word, bookshop, meaning a shop where books are sold. Example sentences. The bookshop gets closed in the evening. The bookshop was very small. Machine, meaning mechanical device. Example sentences. We brought machines from Paris. The fax machine is not working. Next word, finally, meaning after a long time. Example sentences. We finally decided to go to Manali. The results finally got declared. Climb, meaning to go or come up a slope. Example sentences. He climbed the hill easily. My sister climbed the stairs with a stick. Now moving on to the question answers. Why did grandfather give the children money? Grandfather gave money to the children to buy books. Where did they go to buy books? They went to a small bookshop to buy books. Did the girl buy a picture book? No, the girl bought a fat book with many stories in it. In small groups, one child will give directions orally only once. The others will listen and hunt for the following. For this, kindly refer the textbook for the images. A circle, a square, a triangle, a piece of paper with 3 signatures, a piece of paper with red color, a piece of paper with a number, a piece of paper with the label of T, a twig in the shape of an alphabetic letter, a slab of mud with a drawing, a flower in the shape of a number. This is a creative activity to be done along with your friends in the classroom. 1. Now let's come to the question answers. Is there a bookshop near your home? If there is, do you like to visit it? This is a sample answer. Answer may vary from one student to another. Yes, there is a bookshop near my home. Yes, I usually visit it on Sundays when I'm free. Question 2. What are the different kinds of books in this bookshop or in any other bookshop you have seen? Tell the class. And again, this is a sample answer. There are many different types of books available in the bookshop, like mysterious, comedy, drama, and poetry. Look at these sentences in the story. Should we go to the big market? Should we go to the small shop? Should I buy a thin book? The colored words above are describing words. I'll fill in more describing words into the passage below. Now let's see the answers. It was a dark night. A small girl sat up in bed listening to her mother tell a short story. Her blue eyes opened wide and she gave a sweet smile. Now go to sleep, Paro. Her mother closed the book, Sweet Dreams. Imagine that you will go to the bookshop tomorrow. What will you do there? Write 5 sentences beginning with I shall. Let's see. I shall buy a picture book. I shall buy a small story book. I shall buy an encyclopedia. I shall buy a riddle book. I shall buy a sport magazine. Moving on. Tina goes to school library to borrow a book. Complete her dialogue with the librarian by using or, an or in the blanks. Tina. Okay. This is that. Let's see. Come to the answer directly. Tina. Ma'am, I want to borrow a book. Librarian. Do you want a story book or a book of poems? Tina. I want a story book. Librarian. Do you like stories about animals or adventure stories? Tina. I like both. Librarian. Go to the second cupboard. On the first shelf, you will find animal stories, and on the second, adventure stories. Tina, after selecting 2 books, ma'am, I want Black Beauty and Panchatantra stories. Librarian, you can have either Black Beauty or Panchatantra stories. What is your favorite book? Write down the name of the book, then write down the story. Again, this is a sample answer. Students are advised to write the answer based on your experiences and observation. You can say Gulliver's Travel, Alice in Wonderland, Aesop's Fable, Panchatantra,